One of the ways to help keep your business out of the clutches of hackers is to make sure that all your computers and your laptops are running the latest software updates. But I see a lot of people struggle with this. But did you know you can update all your computers and your laptops right within Microsoft 365? And that is what today's video is all about. But before we start, just a quick intro. My name is Jonathan Edwards from Integral IT. Our business helps people all over the world with the Microsoft 365. So why do we need software updates? Well, think about it for a minute. Software is everywhere. We've got a computer, we've got a laptop, and that runs an operating system, something like Windows 10 or Windows 11. But then on that computer or laptop, we've got lots of software as well. What about Outlook, Word, Excel, and PowerPoint? Plus, the hardware in our computers and laptops also needs software to run. These are called drivers. So as you can appreciate, there's a lot of software. But unfortunately, software sometimes needs that little bit of help. Sometimes software manufacturers find security holes with the software. So they release something called a patch, which fixes that security hole. Sometimes software has a performance problem. So again, the software manufacturer might release an update to cure it. And sometimes we just have new updates, new features, and so more software updates are released. Now, if you run a business with just one computer, how can you be sure that all the software on that computer is up to date? What happens if you've got 50 computers, 500, 10,000? You can quickly see that the software update function is going to quickly get out of hand. Now, if you look at any cybersecurity framework in the world, things like Cyber Essentials here in the UK, or CIS, or NIST, all of these frameworks have a big section about how you update the software on your devices. Now, fortunately for you, help is at hand, because you can patch your Windows devices right from Microsoft 365. And today, I'm going to show you how. Now, just a couple of things to mention beforehand. Firstly, all the PCs need to be Intune joined. And secondly, you need to have the appropriate Microsoft 365 license, which gives you access to Intune. Without further ado, let me show you how to update those computers and laptops right within 365. So what you need is to log into the Microsoft 365 portal with an admin account. And you can see that I've got admin permissions here because I've got this little admin button. So I'll click on that and that will launch the Microsoft 365 admin center. Now, what I want to do is go to show all, and I want to scroll down to admin centers here, and particularly I want endpoint manager. So I'll launch that. And once that launches, I just want to scroll down here and click on manage devices, Windows 10 and later updates. Let's launch that. Now you can see I've got several options along the top, and we'll go through each of those in today's video. The first thing we're going to do is create an update ring. Now, an update ring is like an update configuration for your devices in your business. So what I tend to do with my customers is I create at least two update rings. So why do I create two update rings? Well, say if we've got a customer with 50 computers, the first update ring that I create might be targeted at just 5 computers. And what I want is the updates to install on those computers as quickly as possible. And then I can monitor if those updates have caused a problem. And once I'm satisfied that those updates haven't caused a problem, I can then roll out the rest of the updates to the remaining 45 computers. So the first update ring will be that first set of devices. So if I go to create profile, now I will call this update ring one, test devices. Okay, I'll click on next, and then we've got the update ring settings. So where it says Microsoft product updates, of course we want to set that to allow. And what about Windows drivers? That covers all the hardware in the laptops and the computers. We want to set that to allow as well. And then we've got a couple of options here to defer updates for a certain number of days. First of all, we can defer quality updates. So what's a quality update? Well, a quality update is usually a fix or a security improvement to the Microsoft operating system. So why would we want to defer those updates? Well, again, we might let that update get released to the world. We might keep checking online and we might see if that update has caused any problems. So if we set this as a deferral period of say 7 days, that gives us enough time to do that. But in my approach, I like to install these updates as soon as possible on a test number of computers. So I choose zero in here. I don't want to defer that update at all. The next section is the feature update deferral period. So what's a feature update? Well, your PC might run Windows 10, it might run Windows 11, but both Windows 10 and Windows 11 have different versions of their operating system. So if I just go onto this tab here, Windows 11 release information, you can see here that we've got some versions here. Now these are different feature updates. So if we look at the 21H2, for example, it tells us when it came out, and it also says when the end of servicing was. So if you've got a computer running Windows 11, 21H2, it is now end of life and you need to upgrade. Some people just think, well, I've got Windows 11, so I'm okay. That's not how it is. The latest version of Windows 11 is actually 23H2, and that becomes end of life the 11th of November, 2025. So to see what version of Windows 11 you're running, you can simply go to Settings, you can go to System, and you can scroll down here to go to About. And you can see that this PC is Windows 11 Pro 23H2. So I'm okay. So that is what a feature update is. So again, often feature updates don't fix things. There's nothing to do with security. It's just updating you to the latest version. Again, for this update ring, I don't want to defer it. So I'm going to set that to zero as well. Next, we can use update rings to upgrade our devices from Windows 10 to Windows 11. Now, unless you want Armageddon in your business, I would always set this to no. What you don't want is for all your PCs to completely upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. That could be a bit of a nightmare. So always choose no for that. And then the next section is about these feature updates as well, which we talked about here. So what we can do is we can put a number in here, and after the feature update, as long as it's within these days here, we can actually uninstall and roll back. So a nice number to put in here is 30. You can choose anything from 2 days to 60 days. Next section here is about pre-release builds. I would never have these on beta channel, dev channels, just set that to not configured. And then we've got some user experience settings, okay? So how do we want these updates to get installed? These settings here are ideal. So we want to auto install the Windows updates between 8 and 5, depending on when your business works, what time the computer is going to be switched on, switched off, etc. But this is a good setting. We have got other settings as well. We can auto install and then restart during certain times. We can auto install and reboot without end user control. I've just found that these settings here are ideal. Then we've got an option to allow users to pause Windows updates. I don't like that. I think Windows updates should be installed. And then we've got an option to check for Windows updates. So that's just in the control panel where people can check for own Windows updates. I'm okay with that. We can leave that to enabled. And then this section about the notification. So what we can do, we can turn off notifications for Windows updates. We can turn off all notifications, excluding restart warnings. Again, I usually leave this just as it is here. And then we've got some deadline settings. Now, we can choose these to allow. Now, deadline for installing feature updates, deadline for installing quality updates. This isn't as important because what we've done up here is auto-install the updates at a maintenance time. However, if I just selected notify download and the updates weren't installed, then I could put a deadline on here. So I do allow these because also it's talking about rebooting computers. Sometimes what happens is an update is installed on a computer, but that user might never reboot the computer and it's a bit of a pain. So what we can do in here, I will just select seven for there, although they don't really count because of this, and then a grace period of 2 days for them to reboot the PC. And also we've got an auto reboot option that I like to select to yes as well. Okay, click on next. And then who are we assigning this update ring to? Well, if you remember, all these updates get installed straight away. So what I would usually do in this is I would have a group of people. So I would click on add group and I would have a group of computer called test users or something like that. Now I haven't got that here, so I would just choose this group here. But I would create a group called test users. I'd then click on next and then I would create that policy. So that policy is there, but then I would straight away create another update ring. So I'll do that now and I call this update ring to production users. Okay, I click on next. Now I would allow, but this time I'm going to defer these for a longer period. So I'm going to defer those for 7 days. That gives me 7 full days to know if the previous updates installed on my test users have caused any problems. And again, with the feature updates, I will defer those as well. Those will still select to no. This would still be 30. Everything else would be the same. Disable that, keep that enabled, and we will do the same on these as well. Okay, click on next. And then I would add a group called production users and I would assign it to that. Okay, I would just click on there for now, but I would use groups to do that. Click on create. And then I've got my 2 groups. Okay, now we've got our 2 update rings there. Let's move on to the next tab, which is feature updates. Now you might be thinking, feature updates? Didn't we talk about feature updates when we configured the update rings? And yes, we did. So what does this section do? If we create a feature update profile, what does it do? Well, let me use this example. If I call this feature update profile, now the feature update to deploy, you can see here, we previously spoke about different version of Windows 11. So we've got Windows version 23H2. If we go back here, we know that's the most recent version, okay? Now, just for example, if I put the older version in here, so Windows 11 version 22H2, okay, rollout options make update available as soon as possible. If I click on next, if I click on our groups and apply that to all users, click on select, click on next, and click on create. Now, what this will do is no PC in my business will update to the latest version of Windows 11 because I've essentially created a policy saying all I want is my PCs to run that version. So even though in my update rings, I've configured them to download and install feature updates, they will never go past this version. So there might be a reason in your business why you might need to stick at a certain version. However, with these policies, it means that every PC in your business will hopefully be running the latest versions. Now, if you add a computer to your business and it's actually running Windows 11 23H2, it won't downgrade. It will continue to run that version. But this is a handy feature. It means you're controlling the updates a little bit more. Now, for me, there won't be any reason why I'd want to run that version. So what I can simply do is go into it, go into the properties. I can click on edit and I can change that to the most recent version. I know some businesses who want to keep using kind of Windows 10 and certain versions. So this is a handy feature. Go back to there. I've got my feature update profile in there now. Okay, now let's move on to the other tab, which is quality updates. Now, again, you might be thinking, well, we talked about quality updates in the update ring. So what's this section here? Well, let me give you this scenario. So quality updates, a lot of the time, they are security updates. So what happens is Microsoft might find a security problem with one of their products, one of their operating systems. So they, in a hurry, they create this update to fix it and they release it to the big wide world. Now in our update ring, we have deferred quality updates for 7, 14, 21 days. So our devices won't be getting that update until that period has lapsed. So there might be a really critical security update that is out there in the wild and our PCs won't be getting it. So this section here is we can create a profile and we can apply security updates and other updates to our PCs, which override the deferral period that we talked about in the update rings. Again, you don't have to have it along with the feature update section. You don't have to have it. It just helps. So we will create a profile here. we'll call it quality update. And then down here, look, we have got the various different updates that have happened with the dates next to them. So again, there was an update out on the 26th of March. So that's a couple of weeks ago. And if our PCs haven't got that, then we can schedule that. It says number of days to wait before the restart is enforced as well. We can give the users a few days as well. So what we would do, if I select that to maybe this older one, which was the 12th of March, click on next. We're going to include all users, select, click on next, create that profile. So that profile is set. If we go into it, it's that update here. So what we can do then, we can check back every month or so and more updates will appear here. And we can simply just amend this setting to the more recent updates, review and save, and click on save. That's a useful feature. You don't have to use it. You can just let the update rings do their thing. Okay, next we're going to talk about driver updates. So what's a driver? Well, if you think about a laptop consists of lots of hardware. It's got a Wi-Fi card in there. It's got a network card. It's got a mouse tracker. It's got lots of different bits of hardware. Now, when Windows is installed on that laptop, Windows needs to know how to communicate with that hardware. And so that's what a driver is. It's that intermediary between hardware and software. And these are called drivers, okay? So we need to create a driver profile. So we click on there. We can call this driver profile or whatever you want to call it. We can click on next. And then we've got a couple of options here. We can manually approve and deploy drivers. So that's an option. And we will come in and manually do it. Or we can automatically do it. And that again, we've got an option to make updates available after so many days. So we can choose a day in there. I will click on next. I would apply that to all users. Okay, like that. I will click on next and I will create that. Now it might be useful to show you the driver profile in a real customer tenant. Okay, so I'll flip over to that now. Okay, this is a live customer tenant. You can see that we've got a driver profile here. If we go into it. Now, these drivers are set to automatically approve and we've got updates available after 15 days. We can see we've got some tabs along here. Now, the recommended drivers. So you can see that all these drivers have been approved. So there's Logitech, there's Intel, there's lots of different drivers that have been approved because they're automatically set to approve, okay? And the applicable devices that it applies to. We've also got a tab called Other Drivers, and these are the older ones. So usually these drivers in here have superseded the other ones. So these go to Need Review, okay? So that's how the drivers section works. Now, if we just flip back to our test tenant again, and the final thing in this section I want to show you is just the monitoring section, okay? So this is where you will monitor any issues, any devices with conflicts or errors. You will monitor that here, and you can refresh it and things like that. So far, we have talked about Windows operating systems. What about the other applications? We've got applications like Office, we've got Word, Excel, Outlook, PowerPoint, all that. That is done in the same section as here, but we'll just go up to here to configuration, okay? And what we want to do here is we want to create a new policy. We want to select the platform as Windows 10 or later. The profile type needs to be settings catalog. And then we click on create. Okay, we'll name this. So we'll call this MS Office update. Click on next. And then we go to this section here and we want to add settings. So if we type in Office 2016 and it'll search below here. Here we go. So the option we want is Microsoft Office machine updates. And it gives us all these options here. So from here, we want to select enable automatic updates, delay, okay. We want to select the update channel and the update deadline, okay. So we'll have those four settings in here. So firstly, enable automatic updates. Yes, we will select that. Again, we've got a delay, so we can choose that as well. We can delay for, I think it's 0 to 14. So you can say, look, let's delay for 7 days. Again, that's just to test if the update is okay. Again, you can create new multiple profiles for different people in your business. We've then got the update channels here. We can enable that and we can choose our channel. The current channel is fine for this. And then we've got an update deadline. Again, it's similar to the deadline when we talked about the Windows updates. So again, we can select that at 7. Once you're happy with that, you can click on next. You've got your scope size, click on next. And then who are you applying this to? Well, again, as I said, I would create a couple of profiles, but for this example, I will apply it to all devices and all users. Click on next and click on create. Just click on refresh there and it should appear. And there you go. That is updating your operating systems and Microsoft Office in Microsoft 365. So there you have it. That's how to update your Windows devices right from within Microsoft 365. If you're not using update rings today, make sure you do. I look forward to seeing you again soon.